Yeah. Now in Python, Python is a great for processing data. Often a data set will include multiple variables and many instances, making it hard to get a sense of what is going on. Using this Python, we can plot 2D, 3D graphs. And for this, we are using various packages. Particularly, today we see how to use this matplotlib package and the NumPy. Okay. Now see, data visualization using graphs is a quick and easy way to convey concepts in a universal manner, especially to those who aren't familiar with your data. Okay. Python can be used to plot 2D and 3D graphs, which helps in visualizing the data we work with. The graphs can be generated and saved so that they can be included into documents. We can set axis labels, label font, font size, color, etc., grid, line type, color, etc., and a legend for the graphs. Matplotlib is a library in Python for creating static, animated, and interactive visualization. See, here generally what happened? There is many data in statistics or in mathematics, which we have to represent by using graphs or diagrams. Okay. And for this, to draw the graphs and diagram, we use this matplotlib library functions in Python. See, here, matplotlib is a cross-platform data visualization and graphical plotting library for Python, and its numerical extension is NumPy. Matplotlib.pyplot is a collection of functions that make matplotlib work like MATLAB. Okay, each pyplot function makes some change to a figure. For example, creating a figure creates a plotting. Each pyplot function makes some changes to a figure. For example, creates a figure, creates a plotting area in a figure, plots some lines in a plotting area, decorates the plot with labels. I mean, when we draw the figures or graph, we have to give their labeling, and what information we represent by using that graph, we have to also naming in that figure. Okay. Matplotlib allows you to generate high quality line plot, graphs, scatter graphs, curves, surfaces, bar graph, pie charts, 3D plots, histograms, bar charts, and much more. Now, here, from these matplotlib library functions, we import that matplotlib in two ways. First way of importing the matplotlib library as, first, import matplotlib.pyplot as PL. Means instead of writing this, we import this matplotlib.pyplot only by using this PL. And second way of import is from matplotlib.pyplot import star. Okay, here we use star. Now we, to plotting the graphs, we use some functions. So here, which are that functions? We use the arrow functions to add an arrow to the axis, auto scale the axis view to the data axis, add an axis to the current figure, is for adding axis X on or Y, Z axis, we add this axis, bar, we use this function to make a bar plot, contour to plot the contour lines, hist, we use this for plotting a histogram, legend to place a legend on the axis. Means suppose we have to write in figure which notation is used or which we denote the data by which letter. For that, we use the legend. We write that legend either in upper or means at the top or bottom of the graph at left or right corner. X label is used to set the label for X axis. Y label is used to set the label for Y axis. Bar, make a horizontal bar plot. Using bar plot, we can directly get the make a bar plot, but BARH, using this function, we make a horizontal bar plot. Pie, to draw a pie chart, we use this pie. Plot, this function is used for plot y versus x as lines and or markers. Now scatter, we use this scatter functions for scatter plot of y versus show. Using this show we can display all figures. We use table functions to add a table to an axis. To give the title to the functions or axis, we use this title. We use this for given to the figure or axis, anything. Y scale, set the y axis scale. Now see, as we see that we can import the matplotlib library functions in two ways. So we first use here the first way of importing the matplotlib.pyplot as pl function. So see, we use this library for this bar diagram. Suppose we have a subject and marks. This data is given and we have to show or represent this data by using bar diagram. And to show this bar diagram, in Python we use this import matplotlib.pyplot as pl. Okay, so see how we perform the program. I directly copy paste that program here, but we can perform this program in offline mode. For this you have to download Python from Google, install that Python in your PC, and again we can, Python is the editor file, and to show or run we use here Visual Studio Code. Once we install all this Python and Visual Studio Code, VS Code, okay, we call this as a VS Code, then offline also we can run this Python programming. Okay, for online we use the Jupyter Lab, Jupyter Notebook or Colab Notebook. Okay, but when we have to perform the programming in Python offline, we can install that Python from Google. Again we can use the run coder. Okay, install all that in Visual Code, and we can perform the programming in Python offline. Okay, now see here, we consider how to plot a bar diagram using this import matplotlib.pyplot as pl function. Okay, so see here, I perform this program in Python ideally. Okay, and then we run this in Visual Code, VS Code. Okay, so see, in this we first import matplotlib.pyplot as pl. We consider the subjects, or we represent these subjects by x. We list all that subjects using list. We already learned that. Again, corresponding marks of subjects are represented by y. We use import matplotlib.pyplot as pl. So we have to use this pl command here, pl.bar. Means to plot the bar, we use the command pl.bar. Okay, pl.bar. Here, this is x, y, x values, y values, width. We can take here width 0.4, or by default the width is taken. Here, by default the color is taken to be blue, but we can take here any color, red, black, any color we can choose. Okay, for labeling we use the command pl.xlabel. And on x axis we consider subjects offered, on y axis we consider marks obtained, so we label that as pl.ylabel. These are the commands use pl dot y label. Means on y axis we are getting marks obtained, the x axis is labeled by subjects offered. And what is this graph that is shown by this pl dot title command? Okay, bar graph of marks of topper. Okay, and to show this figure, means we have to visualize that bar diagram. For this we use this pl dot show, and here we have to use here empty bracket. Okay, now see, means we first import the library matplotlib.pyplot as pl. Then we enter the values of x, subjects which we have to taken on x axis, corresponding marks which we have to taken on y axis. Again we use the command for, this is the command for bar, okay, for plotting a bar diagram, PL bar. See how to, we can write only x y, which consider that changes afterwards, okay. Here we consider the width as 0.4, color as red, PL dot x label means on x axis we take the subjects offered, on y axis we label the y axis as marks obtained, we give the title to the graph as bar graph of marks of topper. And then the graph is shown by this PL dot show. Using this command we can visualize that bar, okay. Now we run that. See, this is our bar graph, okay. For this we make some changes in our visual code, or we use some shortcut keys in our visual code. Here I use here F6 for run the program, okay. See, so here this is bar graph. See here English 76 marks, Hindi 56 marks, for science here 76, whatever that, maths, this is history. On x axis, this is our x axis where we write the subject offers, this is our y axis we get the marks obtained, and this is the bar graph of marks of topper, okay. Means here the graph is titled, means this is the title of our graph, okay. So this is our first bar graph using the command import matplotlib.python as pl, okay. Now we close this. See, and if I want to, suppose here we can remove this width and color. See what happened. If we remove this and now we run this. Save F6. See, what we are getting here. This is by default, this is the width. See what happened? The graph, we remove that color red. So we are getting here blue color of that graph. And this is the default color. Okay, width again we consider that width as 0.4. Here that width is more than that 0.4. Okay, generally this is 0.8 width. Okay, means we can make the changes according to us. Okay, now next is, okay, now next is from matplotlib. Sorry, we already showed this. Just wait. Now we use the second way of importing the functions from matplotlib.pyplot import star. Here, what is the difference? In that, in first way of importing, here we use the matplotlib.pyplot import star, and in our previous we use import matplotlib.pyplot as pl, means our all commands start with pl dot, okay. But here there is no need, as we use here import star. So again here we use that, or we insert that library from matplotlib.pyplot import star. Again same subjects we are considering, x list of subjects, y list of corresponding marks. Here we only show the graph by bar x comma y, okay. Here we don't write for width, what width we want, which color we want, okay. We only just plot that x y. Here we x label means on x axis we consider subjects, on y axis we give the label as marks, and title for this graph is given as bar graph of marks of x y z student, and this graph is shown by this, show this, okay. So see here, this is in our PPT. Now we consider this in our, just wait. Okay, we close the first graph, okay. Now this is second graph from matplotlib.pyplot import star, okay. We already discussed that. See, and Here we don't consider that PL because we use the library as from matplotlib.pyplot import star. Okay. So see, now we run this by using F6. See here. Okay. Means graphs are same in both the cases. Graphs are same. Only the way of writing the program is different. Which library we consider? Using that, we have to give the commands. Okay. Here we don't use that PL dot because here what? Which library we use here? From matplotlib.pyplot import star. So our command directly start with this bar x label, y label, title. This is the difference between these two ways of importing the library. Okay. Now next is cn. Next is here in this. Okay. This graph is repeated. Okay. I make that changes with 0.4 and color red. Okay. Sorry. This is the repeated graph. Okay. Again, the next way of visualizing the data is histogram. Okay. The next way of visualizing the data is histogram. Okay. See here. Suppose we are given some data edges and we have to represent this graph by using edges. These are the edges of certain persons. Suppose these are the 20 persons and we have to show this data by using histogram. So for plotting the histogram and bar diagram, what is the difference between histogram and bar diagram or bar graph? Anyone else? What is the difference between histogram and bar graph?
Histogram is the series of adjacent bars.
Okay. Histograms means what? It is the adjacent series of rectangles. Okay. And in bar graph, the bars are separated. Okay. So see, in histogram, we divide this. Suppose we are given these are 20 observations. Here we find the largest and smallest observation here. Suppose here for grouping the data, we consider the lowest observation as a 0 and suppose the largest observation as 100. Means total we have 0 to 100. Okay. These are the observations. Suppose 100 observations are there. Okay. 0 to 100, if we both include, it becomes 101. Okay. For our convenience, suppose we consider these are the means lower limit is 0, upper limit is 100. Okay. Now we divide this total 100 observations into equal 5 parts. Okay. And suppose, so here for this, we use here the second way of importing the matplot library, that from matplotlib.pyplot import star. We write here ages. Here lower limit for age is 0, upper limit for age is 100. Okay. And we divide this total observations into 5 equal parts. Now in histogram, we have to use that parts. Means how many, if we make here 5 parts, so we are getting here 5 rectangles. 5 rectangles of equal width. It depends on that. Okay. So here to plot the histogram, we consider age. Okay. Means this is our data. Parts, how many parts we are considering here? 5. Limit, we start with 0 and end with 100, and the width of each rectangle is 0.8 here. Okay, by default this is 0.8, or we can write here 0.8, or we can reduce or increase that. Generally we reduce that. Okay, we write on x-axis age, so x label is denoted by age. On y-axis we have to show the number of persons, so y label we give number of persons. Title for this graph is, or the title for this figure is histogram. And this histogram is shown by this show command. Now see, we consider this in our Python. For histogram. Okay. So we import from matplotlib.py plot import star, edges are given, limit 0 to 100, parts is equal to 5, we have to give parts, same program here, okay, but this is in our VS code. Hist means this important for plotting a histogram in Python, we use this command, hist edge parts limit arg weight. Suppose we use here color also. If we want here color, we can use that color M, X label H, Y label number of persons, title as histogram. And this is shown by this command. See how we are getting that histogram. Okay. See, so you think I already told that the rectangles are adjacent, and here you observe that the rectangles are not adjacent, though in figure, but here we observe that 0 to 20. As we are considering the widths here as 0.8, that's why these are not the rectangle. If we remove the width, what happened? Okay. See, so if we remove the width here as, see, what is the difference? Here, I write here width as this. If we remove this width from this histogram, from this program, see, remove that width, what happened? Now run this. Here, this is the histogram. Now these rectangles are adjacent, and this is our histogram. Okay, means whatever we are giving the width, that width is also considered. If we want histogram, then there is no need to take the width. Okay, so means if we write here width, then we are that histogram looks like a bar graph. Okay.
And ma'am, what if we remove the width in bar bar graph?
Hello,
ma'am. Am I audible?
Voice is quite less.
Okay.
Repeat it.
Ma'am, what if we remove width in bar graph? What will be the result?
Means in histogram, means what is the difference between bar graph and CR? We observe that both are same, commands for same. Means actually in bar only we are using X, Y and sometimes we use that width or not. And in histogram, there is no need to write that width of that rectangle. Okay. Means in histogram, we can write, if we write the width, sometimes means we may think that if in bar diagram we write the width, then in histogram, why we don't write that width? That's why I'm making that changes here. So first I show it by considering the width. If we consider the width, then what happened? We are getting the width of each rectangle according to the given number. But if we remove that, then we are getting all the rectangles adjacent or all the bars. In histogram, generally we call this as a rectangles. Okay, all that rectangles are adjacent. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Now next. Now after here histogram, now again to represent the data, there is another way of representing data, that is pie chart. We generally studied that pie chart, okay, in our school level also, in our college level also. What is pie chart, or how to draw that pie chart? Are you know what is the requirement?
Yes,
for pie chart. Okay. Yes, anyone else?
Pie chart.
For pie chart, what we require? How this pie chart looks?
Circle.
Circle, good. Okay. So see here in this pie chart, this is the circular figure, means in circle we represent the data, and in circle we always want that in degree measures. Okay, the figures we want in degree measure, but in Python, see here, that conversion is already inbuilt. Okay, means from, see here, how to draw this pie chart. Python is very easy because we only use the commands here. There is no need to only what data we are providing, provided here. We use that data, use the commands for that directly. Means actually in programming, we have to make the program using logics. But here, logic is not so used here because all these commands are inbuilt. Means directly if I write here, if we consider this program directly copy paste in Jupyter notebook or in Colab, you are directly getting the answer. Okay, you are directly getting that pie chart. Okay, means these are the inbuilt commands. These are means if we write here pie, give the data, only we have to import that functions first here. Okay, means we have to import that library, then give the commands here or function here, and then using that we are getting the what we want. So see here, again we import from matplotlib.pyplot import star. Okay, we can make the same programming using our second way of importing the library. Okay, so see here, suppose this is our x values are 600, 4000, 1200, 400, 1000. We use the labeling as we consider here list. You already learned that clothing, food, rent, fees, miscellaneous. In pie chart, only we want the values of x and labels. So the command for this pie chart is x comma labels. Labels are denoted by L, and title for this is given by pie chart. To show this, we have to write here show. Now we consider how we are getting that pie chart. See, this is our program from matplotlib.pyplot import star. Give the values of x in list, y, l as this. Pie x comma labels is equal to l. Title pie chart. Show this. Okay. Now if we run this, programs are very easy in Python. See, we are getting this. See, this is food, clothing. This is miscellaneous, fees, rent. This is circle. Okay, so this is our pie chart, and these colors are again directly given by that. Okay, means there is no need to represent. Generally, in school days, what we do, we represent that every label by some colors or by some shading. But in Python, we are directly getting that different colors. Okay. Now next, now scatter diagram. Generally these scatter diagrams are used in statistics. Okay, but as this is the part of diagram, so we consider that. In this, what we do, we are given two types of data: girl score, boy scores. Means when we have to consider some data which contains two variable, girl score, boy score, and this is our score range. Okay, so again we import the library as from matplotlib.pyplot import star. Okay, as in this library there is no need to always write that pl dot, so it is easy to use this library. Okay, so here girl score, we write, give the data like this: girls underscore scores is equal to, again consider the list, boys underscore scores is equal to list of the score. Score range is like this: 10, 20, 30. Means on x axis we are considering this 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. So we have to consider the larger, means smallest and largest limit, and according to that we have to give here score range. So we first consider, or we first draw the scatter for girl score. Okay, for that we give, means we have to use here two scatters. Scatter first, scatter score underscore range, girl score, we label that by girls. We denote that by using the color R, that is red. Marker means we use for girl score, we use your star. Okay. Now for boys, we use this scatter score underscore range, see same thing, girl score, here we write boys, under, underscore scores, label, as we have to show the score for boys, so we write here boys. Again, we use here a different color to distinguish that scatter. G, marker, means we use the marker as D, that is diamond. Okay, S is equal to 30. Now, X label, on X axis, we are considering score under range. Okay, means this score range. 10, I already tell that this, we take this on X axis, score range. Okay, on Y label, frequency, frequency of each score. And the title is my scatter plot. See here, what is a legend? And here we use the legend command. Means in this legend, as we use here for girls, marker we use star. So in that legend, we write star for, star used for girls, D, diamond used for boys. Okay, this is written in legend. Okay, see here. Now we see how we are getting that scatter diagram. Okay, see here. This is our program. From matplotlib.pyplot import star, we already discussed that girl score, boy score, score range, scatter. You have to only remember these things. How to give the command scatter, score range first, then after that score, girl score, label, what label we have to use, girls, color R, and marker that star. Okay, for both this X label, on X axis we have to write score range. Means on X axis, we consider the score range. On Y axis, we consider the frequency. That's why Y label we give as frequency. X label we give as score range. And title of this graph is my scatter plot. Okay, now this is our CR. This is called the legend. Okay, this representation is called as legend. And this is our scatter plot. CR on X axis, score range. Up we are considering 10, 20. Here as our graph is, means for this window is small, so that's why we are considering here 20, 40, 60, 80, 100. These are the frequencies. Okay, so like this. So this is here. These are the girls scatter diagram. Girls and diamond for boys. This is our scatter diagram. Generally, this is the part of statistics. In mathematics, we generally not use this scatter plot. Okay. Now next,
ma'am, what is this S equal to 30 here?
Okay, means limit for this. See, yeah, just wait. Yeah. If we run this here, yeah. S is equal to 30. Just wait. S is equal to girl score. Means generally we can represent here, if we consider that diagram here, scatter diagram. Generally, sorry, I will tell you that in Telegram, I will message that, but I don't remember that S. Okay, I will tell you that in, I will message you afterward. Okay.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. This is our scatter diagram. Now we use, we generally already use that command, but we write here as we finish our diagrams, we go towards our 2D plot. So commands used for plotting 2D graphs. These commands, plot X, Y, plotting the points. Plot X, Y means we have to plot that point. X label, we use this command for naming the X axis. Y label, we use this command naming the Y axis. Title, we written like this, title of graph, giving a title to graph. Show, function to show the plot. Legend, function for legend. I just explained that, what is legend. Figure, figure size, mn, means for graph of size m by n. Okay, so these are the commands used for plotting of 2D graphs. Now suppose we can see here, in how many ways we can plot a point in our Python. Okay, so these are the different styles of plotting a point. So again, we import the library as from matplotlib.pyplot import star. This is the first way plot. See, this is x value or x coordinate, y coordinate, and this point is represented by DG means here diamond. Okay, x value, y value, and this is the symbol used for that point. Okay, this is first way. Second way, suppose second point, we use x value as 22, y coordinate as 100. We represent this point by plus on our graph. Plot 30, 50, star K, black star. Plot 10, 20, orange. Okay, so x label, x axis, y label, y axis, title, plotting of points. Here, how we get the plotting of points graph? Here, this is graph. We have to plot this 4 point. Okay, here I, for our convenience, we add here one more point, 70, 35 color, maroon, and symbol is used for this. Okay, we can add here color also. Means we can take any color, which color we want. Means instead of here, we write there plus a star K. Here star means star maroon color. See, star is in maroon color. Okay, so here the graph is like this. See, these are five. Okay, this is maroon. So these are the points. Here first point is if I want, here first point is diamond 25 17, here x 25 y 17, here this is the point diamond. Second point plus, what is that? 2200. Here 20, so this is the point 2000. Okay, again next point is okay, that becomes very, very small. Just wait, sorry, So these are the different points. Means this is 30, whatever that. This is 70, something like this. So these are the plotting of points in 2D. Only we have to, how to plot that? Only we have to give plot x value, means x coordinate, value of x coordinate, y coordinate, and we which symbol we have to use, that we have to write here. Okay, this is plotting of points. After points, what come in 2D? We first plot the point, then what comes? Point. After point, what will be there?
Line.
In line. Good. We next see how to plot a line. And here we can, for plotting a line graph, we have different forms of line, that is 2-point form, slope intercept form. Okay, like that. So we first see 2-point form of plotting a line. Means suppose we are given 2 points, and using that 2 points, how to plot a graph. So see here, again we import the library as from matplotlib.pyplot import star. We use this library generally because in this our work is less. Here there is no need to write pl dot every time. That's why I am using this library. Import numpy as np. Actually, we are considering here point in matrix form. That's why we are using here numpy as np. Okay. There is no need to write this also, import numpy, because we are not use that extension here. So x is equal to 10. This is our first point. Sorry, this is not first point. Is like this. These are the x coordinate, x values of a point 10. Means this is x1. This is x2. Means these are the x coordinate, y, 4, 3. These are x values, y values, not this is x point and not this is one point and this is another point. These are the x value of first point, x value of second point, y value of first point, y value of second point. Remember that thing. X, this is the list for x values of points. This is the list for y values of point. Okay. So Serodi's command we use here. Plot x comma y. Color we suppose represent that line by green color. Label line joining two points. Here I already told you that these are for x coordinate 1 0. 4 3 are y coordinates. That's why we are considering the point 0 3 and 1 4. Yeah, yeah, 0 3 and 1 4. Otherwise, you are thinking, madam, written like this here 1 0 4 3, and they are saying she is saying that line joining 0 3 and 1 4. That's why I explain here that these are the x values, these are the y values. Okay, x label x axis, y label y axis, title line graph. Again, we use that legend. And show here means only command is that plot x y, okay, and we give here using line joining 0 3, means we have to write line joining what, the 0 3 and 1 4 point. See, and we are getting this program.
Sir, real assistant aaya hai.
Hello. Yeah. Import now. We first import that library from matplotlib.py. Plot import star, import numpy as np, x value, y coordinate, values of y coordinate. Plot this x label, y label, title line graph, legend show. Okay, if we run this, see, yeah, this is the line joining that two points here, 0 point. This is x axis, this is y axis. This is 0.0 here. This is 0.03, and last point is 1 4 here. X axis 1, y axis is here 4 1 4. So this is the line joining the point 0 3 1 4. Okay. Now next one. Now next is slope intercept form. Okay, slope intercept form, that is y is equal to mx plus c form. In this, m is the slope of the line and c is the y intercept. So see here. So for in this we use the linspace command. Okay, np dot linspace. So we import the library as from matplotlib.py plot import star, import numpy as np. X, we define the x, means here we have to give the range for x. X is, means we define the x values like this. X is equal to np dot linspace. Here this is the lower limit or lower value, or this is called start point, this is called end point, or last value, this is first value. And here this 100 is used for how many points we want. This is how many points we want. Initial value, end value, this 100 is for use for number of points. As we are calculating the values of x by using this np dot linspace, we use that value for calculating y. Y is equal to 2 star x plus 1. And we now we plot the graph of this line. Plot x y dash minus r, this is the color, label is this. Y is equal to 2x plus 1. And we give the title as graph of y is equal to 2x plus 1. X label, x color, there is no need to write this color. We can remove that. And legend, this legend means location to upper left. Grid means here, what is the difference between grid and this? We consider this difference by considering the plot. Okay. This is x value, means x is calculated by using this np dot linspace, means from minus 5 to 5, we start with minus 5, end with 5, up to 100 points. We are calculating 100 numbers here. Okay, so y is calculated by using this formula 2 star x plus 1. plot x y. R label y is equal to 2x plus 1. Title x label y label legend. See here. How we are getting that line? This is the line. Okay. Now see here. We use that grid command here. Here. So what is the use of that grid command? Remember this graph. Now we close this graph. And suppose I remove the grid command. If I remove this grid command, then what happened? Now run this. What do you observe here? Means what is the use of that grid command? What is the difference between these two graphs? Previous one and this one.
Hello, in the previous graph, grid is present and here is grid is...
We are getting boxes there. Okay, means like that graph papers.
Yeah, follow.
Good. Okay, so this is the use of that grid function. Okay, now next, this is our slope point form. Means we can plot a line using this slope point form. In this, we calculate the value of x using np dot linspace. Then calculate the value of y and use this command to get the graph. Okay. Now next one, after line. Line means this is the linear, okay, or polynomial of degree one. This is linear function or polynomial of degree one. So now next we have to consider the plot for degree two. So give me the examples, some example of this degree two polynomial or curve or function or some graph.
Parabola.
What?
Parabola.
Parabola, good. Okay, so now we consider the next for means plotting graph of y is equal to x square, means quadratic plot, okay. Again, we import the library as from matplotlib.pyplot import star. Import numpy as np because we are using that np linspace. Again, same way x is equal to np.linspace. See here, we don't write that how many points we want. So ultimately, take the even list space point, minus 15, 15. By default, the points are taken. Here, y is equal to x square. We use the command here, plot x, y. X label is x values. Here graphs are same. Only we have to consider the functions. Here y is equal to x square. Previously we consider y is equal to 2x plus 1. Different plots we are considering here. And title for this is graph of x versus its square. X versus its square means x versus its square means y is what? X square. Okay. And this is shown by this show command. So now using graph. Sorry. Okay, see here. From matplotlib.pyplot import star, import numpy as np, x is equal to np.linspace minus 15, 15, y is equal to x square, plot x, y, x label x values, y label y is equal to x square. Okay, or y values we can say, sorry here, we want here y values. Just wait, yes, y values, okay. Title graph of x versus its square. See what graph we are getting here. See, this is the parabola. See, this is the origin here. Here, this is the origin and this is parabola is symmetric about, suppose this is y axis, okay. This is our parabola. Okay, so this is the graph of parabola. Now after quadratic, there will be a cubic polynomial. So now we consider a plot for cubic polynomial. plotting graph of y is equal to x cube minus 5x plus 10. Okay. Now there is no need to explain this. We only just see how the plots we are getting here. Okay, because one and the same things are here, only we have to change the functions. Here, this is the graph of y is equal to x cube. In Python, we are easily draw any type of graph using simple commands. Okay, or simple function. Actually, these are not commands. We are using that function, simple functions.
Ma'am, what if we want to add a line at x equal to 0 and y equal to 0 in it?
X is equal to 0.
Yeah, like I want to highlight the x-axis and y-axis in the plot.
Okay, we can use the colors also for that. Huh? In next, we see that. Okay?
Okay.
That will be seen in our next slide. Okay? Plotting of this. Okay? Now, this plotting graph of y is equal to sine x. Okay. So, see here. If we have to plot the graph, y is equal to sine x. You already familiar with this graph. This is a wave graph. This is also called as wave graph because its nature is like wave. Okay. So, see here again from matplotlib.py plot import star, import numpy as np. Here we consider again same x np dot linspace minus 4. Here we take this pi, pi is denoted by this np dot pi. For pi, we use this minus 4 star np dot pi, comma 4 star np dot pi. Means our range is from minus 4 pi to 4 pi. And here we are considering only 10 points. And then we plot the graph y is equal to, plot the graph by using this y is equal to np dot sine x. Sorry, means y is this. Y is equal to np dot sine x. It calculates the value of corresponding values of y. From this, we are getting the values of x. From this, we are getting the values of y. And using this plot x comma y. Here we denote this by red because in the same graph, we consider two plots. Okay. By considering the different number of points. In first graph, we consider only 10 points. In second, we consider here 1000 points. We can see here, we don't have to write that point here. We have to only show that. So we can take here any figure, any number of points we can take here. So x1 is np dot linspace minus 4 np, same range we are considering. Only what change we make here, we only increase the number of points here. We only increase the number of points, and that's why we are denote this by x1, y1. Plot x1 comma y1 show. First plot is shown by this red color. Second is obviously in blue. Okay, so see here. From matplotlib.py plot import star, import numpy as np, x is equal to np dot linspace minus 4 np dot pi. Comma 4 star np dot pi 10 means range of x is minus 4 pi to 4 pi, number of points are 10, y is equal to sine x, okay? Same for this x1, y1. Here, what is the difference between these two? We are considering here two sine waves by considering two different number of points. Here, 10, we increase the number of points here. See what we are getting here. See here. Red. Red means first graph. In this, we are considering only 10 points. That's why, see, this is our first point. Okay, so this is plotting of sine graph. Similarly, if we change this sine by cos, we are getting that cos graphs here. Yeah? Suppose we make that changes. If we consider here, instead of sine, we consider one we consider for cos, another we consider for sine. What happened? Okay, in any one functions, I have to change that. What happened? We cannot use that. E cos. If I write here cos. Cos x1, I write the same number of points, 10 points here. Control S, F6. See here, red is for sine and blue is for cos. Blue is for cos. Okay, so this is the graph for sine and cos. Now plotting graph using conditions. We already learned in our previous lectures that how to use that if, else, return. Okay, so we directly use that here. From matplotlib, now we directly consider the program here. Sorry. Program plotting of this program we want. Okay. So here again we import that library from matplotlib.py plot import star def f of x is f of x colon. We use the condition if x less than 10, then take y as x square. This is quadratic. Else means if x this condition, if x is not like this, then what we have to take? Means for x greater than 10, we have to take y is equal to 5x plus 100. Return y. Here x values, y values. And we have to stop that somewhere. So we use the range function here or for I in range of 0, 21. 1 is smallest value is 0, 21, step size is 1. Okay. X append I, x takes the append I, y dot append f of I and plot x, y, m, x label x axis, y label y axis, and this is our graph for condition. So we label this as, or we give title to this graph as my first graph with if, and show this. See how the graph looks like. See here. For less than or equal to 10, it is a quadratic. X square. Okay, and for remaining it is a line, straight line. See, we are getting that line here. This is the straight line according to that point. What points we are considering here? 0 to less than 10, for equal to 10. So for here 10, for 10 here, like this, and then here this is the straight line. Means using if else, if also, if else, we can plot a graph. Okay, now next. Now we have to plot a 2D polygon. So using Python else, we can plot a 2D polygon. Polygon means we can plot here triangle, rectangle, pentagon. Okay, suppose we have to plot here triangle and rectangle. For a triangle, we required 3 vertices, means 3 points. For rectangle, we required 4 vertices, means 4 points. So here how we have to give here in the values of x. So from matplotlib.py plot import star, import numpy as np. Here we return the x coordinate of each vertex. And see here, you think that there are only 3 points for a triangle. We first consider for a triangle. But here we return 4 values for x. So we know that triangle is a closed figure, means starting and end point coincides. That's why we use x is equal to 1, 4, 9, 1. First and last values are same. Y is equal to here 2, 7, 5. Last value will be 2. And then plot x, y. We label this as a triangle ABC. Okay. So see, next. We denote this by x is equal to np dot matrix. Here we consider here polygon. Here we are considering 1, 1, 4, 4, 1. Y is equal to, say instead of this, we consider that program. We are getting the clear idea about that. See here, plotting of 2D polygon. See here, we are getting here clear idea about that. See here, import number, first we import that from matplotlib.py plot import star, import numpy as np, x is equal to 1491. X values coincide first and last. Y is equal to 2752. Means here, first and last value of y coincides. Plot xy, label is triangle ABC. So we write this in matrix form. X is equal to np dot matrix 11441. Y is equal to np dot matrix 25522. Okay. So here x1 is x here 0, this is the position of that. Means position of x coordinate in a matrix 0, 0. Here for g, when we write the x coordinate of first one. Hello? Any problem?
Ma'am, why you take, yes, ma'am. Why you take like that x and y np matrix 11441 and how this, it works? I don't get it.
Okay, okay. I see, yeah. Just wait. We first see x1, y1, then we see by considering that plot, we are triangle. Now, 1, 1. Actually, I think the values. Just wait. I just only.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. See here. As we are considering here two polygon, that's why we write like this. Means here we consider triangle and rectangle in the same plot. That's why we are writing like this here. One plot. Just wait. Here. The points for this triangle we use one. One, five, four, five, four, two. Okay. Means for triangle, we consider the x values as 1491. Okay. Y values as 2752. Repeat. Okay. And for rectangle, what we do, what we take here? For rectangle, 1144. Last value will be 1. And for y, we consider 2552. Last value will be 2. And that's why we write there like this. See, that's why we are writing 11441. See, in one graph, we have to show both this triangle and rectangle. That's why we are given here this 1144. Means for triangle, we required this 4.4 values of x. And for rectangle, we required 5 values. That's why we are considering this. Here, y is equal to np dot matrix. Here, 2. I think there is some mistake is there. 2752 2. This will be, just wait. What is that point? Just wait. I write that point. Here, what are the points? That points are like this. 1 2 4 7 9 5 1 2 1 5 4 5 4. Okay. Now see here. For triangle, what we want here? 1 1 4 9 1. For triangle, we want 1 4 9 1. For rectangle, we want x values as 1, 1, 4, 4, and we have to end with 2. Okay, because for rectangle 1, 2, 1, 5, x coordinate repeated, 1, 1 repeated twice. That's why we written here 1, 1, 4 repeated twice, 4, 4, and end point as 1. Okay, as we want this in one graph, triangle and rectangle, that's why we are using, we directly write the x coordinate, means we only plot that xy point there and we join that for a triangle which we want, and for rectangle we join the points which we required for rectangle. So here y coordinate for triangle are 2, 7 and 5. Okay, for a triangle there is 2, 7, something is mistake here, just wait. 2, 7, 5 we want here. We have to change. See, we can take here 7 for rectangle. We have to make here. Just wait. I change this by 5. Okay. 2, 5, 5, 2. And here we consider. Okay. 2, 5, 5, 2, 2. Y coordinate for rectangle. Okay. So, see, x1 means we have to totally, we have to plot how many points? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here we have to plot here 1, 2, 1, 5, 4, 5, 4, 2, 1, 2. Okay, this point 1, 2, 1, 5, 4, 5, 4, 2, 1, 1. See here x1 is equal to x of, means what is x1? X1, y1 is first point P1. Suppose we denote this by, suppose we denote that triangle by ABC. So what is the A point here? 1, 2. 1, 2 means position of this is, we want x coordinate of first point, that is we want 1. So how we write that? While writing the x position of x point, we use first as a 0, 0, 0. Means here x coordinate of first point. Okay, x 0, 1 means x coordinate of second point. We know that, we already learned that for index in Python, we use start index with 0, 1, 2. That's why we start with 0. This is first point whose x coordinate, position of x coordinate of first point, position of x coordinate of second point, position of x coordinate of third point, position of x coordinate of fourth point, position of x coordinate of fifth point, means that coincides with our first point. Okay. Here similarly for y coordinate, y1 means y coordinate of first point. While writing the position of y coordinate, in place of x, we write 0, okay? And for y coordinate, we write 1, okay? See here, something is wrong here. 0 here may be, just wait, I'm making some mistake here. I will change that. 0, 1, 0, 2, this is 0, this 1. We want this as 1, okay? 1 we use for y coordinate, means this is the y coordinate of first point, this is the y coordinate of second point. See, this is the y coordinate of third point. Here we have to write, I have to write here, just wait, 0, here is 1, here 2, here is 3, this 1 is fixed here, because we want y coordinate, okay, we want here y coordinate, this is 4 point, and this is, we want y coordinate of last point, okay. Plot x1, y1, label rectangle PQRS, rectangle is denoted by this PQRS, color red, grid, title, polygon, plus. Here, now we are getting that x6. Something is wrong there. What happened? Just wait, something is wrong there. X0, 0, 01, 02, 03, 04, y01, 11, 21, 31, 41 ना. So these are the x coordinate ना, and these are the y.
Ma'am, maybe you can first print x1 and y1 and check what are they.
Okay, we have to give here print. As we want plot, so we cannot print that. We directly use that. Okay. So we have to only consider how the graph looks. That's why I'm not print taking that print statement here. What mistake is shown here? X0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 1, 0, 3. Get item line 9 in module. What happened? 2D line 9. Y1 has here 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1 instead of this 4, 1. We have to consider this as last one, no? There is no mistake. Y1 is Y01, 11, 21, 31, 41.
But there are only three values, that is 0, 1, 2, and 3, not 4, 4. There is no 1.
See here, but the values here we are considering. That's why, just wait. See here, if we remove this, only we consider this, what happened? X1, Y1 plot. We have to consider that separately. 1, 4, 9, 1. We are not considering that 9. 1, 4, 9, 1. Something is wrong there. Just wait. 0, 4, 1,
4, 4, 2, 9, 4, 3, and 1, 4, 3. That no one is 4, 4. So last time 0, 4 is not 3.
See, we are getting the graph like this, but why we are not getting like this? See, just wait, one.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, here is a y point is 2752, and you take there is 2552.
That's why. Okay. Just wait. 7 5. Okay, if we change that, see what happened. 2752. Okay. See what happened.
Ma'am, here is 5, but
here is.
Here is 7.
What?
Yes, now is correct.
Okay. Control S.
Hello, ma'am. Of high coordinate NP matrix, there is 7.
What y coordinate?
NP matrix, there is 2, 2, 5, 2, 2. Here is 5.
2, 7, 5, 2, 5, 5, 2, 1. See here, we remove, if only draw first rectangle, okay? We write only for rectangle. We remove this program. Just wait. We switch shape. Sorry. We have to only write for a triangle, na? Okay. So suppose I remove this. 1, 4, 9, 1. Okay. 2, 7. Just wait. Okay. I understand what mistake I'm making here. 2, 7, 5, 2. Okay, see here. See, this xy is used for triangle and this xy is used for rectangle. No? So just wait. 1, 1, we want here. 1, 1. I'm taking that 1, 1, 4. See, we just only 1. 1, 4, 4, y coordinate I'm taking, 4, 1, okay? And for x coordinate, 2, 5, 2, 5, 5, 2, 2, 5, 5, 2, 2. Okay, now see what happened. Yeah, this coordinate, first x, y are for triangle and second x, y are for, we are using this for rectangle. No?
Rectangle.
Then what happened? Something is okay. Without wasting time, we proceed further. I only show you the graph of that, what that graphs look like, because I have to show more slides here. Graph is like this. So there is some mistake, okay? But I don't understand which is that mistake, okay? See here, this. The graph looks like this, okay? Okay, we remove that because here time is going on. Okay, we have to time up to 1:30 only, no? So say reflection through y is equal to x line. Now I just go fastly. See here. Reflection through y is equal to x line. So from matplotlib.pyplot import star, import numpy as np, we want to plot x axis, y axis, and the line y is equal to x. For axis, we consider, see here, for axis, we are considering this. P is equal to minus 10, 10. Q is equal to 0, 0. Plot PQ label axis color K. K means black color. Plot QP color K. Plot PP color K. This is for x axis. This is for, see here, this is first plot is for x axis. This is for y axis. This is for line. P, y is equal to x, no? That's why we are written here, PP. Now, sir, what is our input of x and y coordinates in cyclic manner? Means we write the x, and here I mentioned that x, y coordinates in cyclic manner. X is equal to np. Suppose this point is 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 2, 6. Okay. So these are the four points. Here we write that x1 coordinate like this. Here use, by considering this program, you can easily understand our previous programs here. X1 is x00, x10 means here we consider the x coordinate of first point, x coordinate of second point, x coordinate of third point, x coordinate of fourth vertex or fourth point, and this is the last one. Huh? I think we are making mistake here. In our previous program, okay? This is the y coordinate. Y coordinate of first point, which we represented by like this, x01, x11, 21, 31, 01. We draw here polygon ABCD. Means using this, we are getting the polygon. And now we have to reflect that polygon through y is equal to x line. Y is equal to x means if we consider the reflection through the line y is equal to x line, what happened? That quad, there is only change in coordinate, means x coordinate become y and y coordinate become x. Here y is equal to x, x become y, y becomes x. So the, if we consider here using transformation matrices, Txy is equal to y. So you already learned that transformation matrices somewhere. So in this, x coordinate become y, y coordinate becomes x. So if here we directly write here by y is equal to x line is there, and we have to reflect the given polygon through this line, then we only change the position of that x and y coordinate. We write here y1, x1 label. Here we write x1, y1 for plotting a polygon ABCD. And when we apply their transformation reflection through y is equal to x, then the right, then the polygon gets reflected. Means the coordinates, x coordinate become y, y coordinate become x. So here we only write that y1, x1, reflection through y is equal to x. And that reflected polygon is shown by red color. Okay, so see here. If we run this, see here, see here, this is our legend. This is the y-axis. This is our x-axis. This is the line y is equal to x. This is our original polygon, ABCD. And this is our reflected polygon or transformed polygon. In this way, the reflection takes place. Okay. So this is the, similarly, we can reflect this. If we consider the line y is equal to minus x, the line is like this. Okay. We can reflect through y is equal to minus x line. We can reflect this polygon through this x-axis also. Means if this is our original polygon ABCD, if we reflect this about x-axis or reflect through x-axis, we are getting that polygon here. If we reflect through y-axis, we are getting that polygon here. Okay. So we, without wasting time, we go further. Okay. Now next. Okay. So next is 2D scaling. Scaling means, see here, in this scaling what happened? We have to increase the dimension of that given polygon either in both x and y axis, or means only in x or only in y. Means this scaling is only to reduce or expand the size of given polygon. So see here, from matplotlib.py plot import star, import numpy as np, plot x axis, y axis. Again, see here, this is for plotting x and y axis. Okay, we are using here different values, minus 520, Q00, plot PQ label axis, color K, plot QP. One is x axis, this is y axis, this is x axis. Input x and y coordinates in cyclic manner, see here. X is np, see here, these are the points. And these are the positions. These are the positions. See, and now we have to, we first plot our original polygon. That is, suppose polygon, say this is not actually not square ABCD, because the 1, 2, 1, 4, 3, 4, 3, 2. Okay, we are getting the square ABCD. Okay. So here, if we have to scale, we have to use here scaling, means we have to increase the only x size of, means if we are considering here square ABCD, we have to increase, or scaling means we have to reduce or expand that figure. So uniform scaling by factor 4. Uniform scaling by factor 4 means we have to increase x and y coordinate in multiples of 4. Okay, so for this T1 is, so we use here a transformation. We have to increase, see here, for original XY, we use here 1, 1, means 1, 0, 0, 1. Transformation matrix means T of X. T of X is XY. So in matrix notation, we write like this, 1, 0, 0, 1. 2 by 2 matrix, 1, 0, 0, 1. Column matrix is XY. So here, for uniform scaling by factor 4, we use the matrices, means in place of x, write 4. Because we have to scale that x coordinate by 4. So right here, in place of x, write 4. Y coordinate 0, because there is no change in y. Uniform scaling in y coordinate by 4. So in place of y, we write here 4. Y x coordinate is 0. Now we have to apply this transformation matrix to each point. Okay, to each point, and that's why we write here the position of this position of the point. So see here, we want the transform point by using this command image one. We write only image, but as in one graph I included all the three types, means in uniform scaling, means we have to expand that, we have to reduce that, and different scaling. That's why we are using here image one, image two, image three. Image one is x star t1, means only on this first vertex we apply the transformation matrix by using this command image, by using this image one is equal to x star t1. Okay, so this is x1, image of x1, means instead of x1, x here we write the image of this point, means x coordinate of this point, transform point. Okay, x command x values of transform point, y values of transform point, and it label is plot x1 y1. Okay, similarly for uniform scaling by factor 1/3, so in place of x right here 1/3, y keep as it is 0 1/3. Okay, so here again image 2 is obtained by x star t2. Again we write that x2 y2. Non uniform scaling means in x and y we consider the different scaling. Suppose we consider we have to reduce that x coordinate, so I write here 0.5, and we have to increase that y coordinate, so I write here 2. Means scaling in x coordinate by 0.5, scaling in y coordinate by 0.2. non uniform scaling. So image 3 is x star t3. Okay, so plot this grid, all three scaling. If we run this, see here these are the axes, x axis, y axis. This is our red square ABCD. This is our original. Okay, this is expansion by factor 4. This is reduction by factor 1/3, and this is for non uniform scaling. Here x factor, here this x value decreases and this y value increases. Okay, so this is the all scaling: original, expansion, reduction, non uniform scaling. Now next, okay, we take somewhat fast here. Shearing, okay. In scaling, we only change the size. Okay, means either we can expand or we can reduce. But in shearing, the shape of the polygon also changes. See here, from matplotlib means for changing the size, sorry, changing the shape, we use here shearing. So again, same thing, we have to only change the transformation matrices. Other program is same for scaling, shearing. Okay, shearing in x direction. So I don't explain this, I directly come to this. Shearing in x direction by factor 3. Shearing in x direction by factor 3 means we have to increase the x value of the point or x coordinate of the point by factor 3. Means there is only change in x coordinate, y coordinate remains as it is. See here, so our transformation matrix, usual transformation matrix is 1 0 0 1. So see here, first column is for x, second column is for y. As we have to increase the x coordinate by factor 3, so in first column of x we write first element 1 and second element as 3. Okay, in column of x, and second column is for y. As there is no change in y, so in first means in 1 2 place, first row, second column, we write 0. Yes, what? Hello, any doubt? Hello. Okay, see, means we have to shearing in x direction by factor 3, means we have to increase the x coordinate of a point by 3. Okay, so in in transformation matrix 1 0, for point 1 0 0 1, so in place of x, first column is used for x, so we write here for x 1, in column of x write 3, below one write 3, and in column of y, in first position write 0 as it is, and in second keep the position of y as it is 3 1. So we have to multiply, means we have to transform every point of original polygon by using this matrix. So image 1 is x star t1. Okay, then store that images like this in x1 y1, plot that. So this is the shearing in x. See how this look. Shear. This is our original polygon square ABCD, and using the shearing, we are getting this. Okay. Now next one, rotation. So next one is rotation. Again, same from matplotlib.pyplot import star import numpy as np. Write x coordinate, y coordinate, we plot triangle, NP matrix, okay? And here we use only plot. For rotation, sorry, this is our polyline. Sorry, by mistake. I have to open this. Sorry. 2D rotation, okay? Again, we plot here from matplotlib.py plot import numpy as np to plot coordinate axis. This is same thing. We input, we draw here, we plot rectangle ABCD. This is for original, okay? And now we have to use that rotation. T is equal to float input. Now we have to rotate, means we have to use rotate that polygon through some angle. So T is equal to float input rotation angle in radian. We use that angle in radian and we consider here transformation matrix for transformation coordinates for that rotation, or we call this as a matrix for rotation also. R is equal to np dot matrix, np cos t comma np sin t. This is first row in, first array in our matrix, minus np dot sin t comma np dot cos t, second array in matrix, first row, second row in matrix. And then image A, IMA, means image A, we denote this by x star r, means we have to multiply every, or we have to transform every point using this rotation matrix. And this is done by using this x star r. And after that, we are getting that polygon. See here. See what we are getting. See, so rotation angle in radians, we have to write in radians. So here we know that pi is 3.14. So I directly write here. If I write here 3. Value of pi as 3.14. Okay, means rotation angle in radian, that is pi. We are getting here. This is our rectangle ABCD, and after rotation through 180 degree means 3. Pi radian. 180 degree means pi radian. We are getting this rotated figure. Okay, if I change here. Again, if I change here some, if we take the pi by 2 angle, pi by 2 means 1.57. Now I directly consider in figures 1.57. Yeah, 90 degree rotation. Okay, like this. So this is the rotation. Can I continue or stop, because some slides are remaining there, some programs are remaining.
Ma'am, you can continue. Continue, ma'am.
Continue. Okay, now next is 2D translation. Translation means shift of origin, or we have to shift the polygons or shift the some figures. Okay, so here again program is same. Here I don't explain this again. Input x dot y, suppose this is our pentagon we are considering here. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these are the 5 vertices pentagon. Okay, and now we translate that translation in x and y direction by factors l and m. L and m means we give the value in our means while running the program, we give the values l and values for l and m. L means what? Float, include, input, enter translation factor in x direction, and m is equal to float input, enter translation factor in y direction. Means L gives the translation in x, m gives the translation in y. Okay, means we have to only use the shift of origin formulae. So the points are x2 is here. We change the x coordinate by adding L and y coordinate by adding m. Okay, so x2, y2, plot x2, y2, color is M, maroon. Here, what we are getting after using translation. X direction, suppose I give 2. Y direction, suppose I give here 5. Here, that get translation. Okay, this is our original pentagon. This is our original pentagon, and this is the translated pentagon. Original translated. Okay. Now next one is 3D axis, okay? 3D axis plotting. See here, now how to plot the 3D axis. See here, generally we cannot plot these 3D graphs manually. So see here, using programming side, there are some various programming. Using this, we can plot the 3D graphs. So see here, using Python, how to we plot that? From matplotlib.py plot import AX. We have for 3D plotting, we have to use this functions. AX is equal to axis, projection is equal to 3D, X label X, Y label Y, and we consider Z like this. AX dot Z underscore Z label, denote by Z, and plot 3D axis plot. So using this only we get the 3D axis plot, means only 3D coordinate system, X, Y, Z coordinate system. See here, this is our X axis, this is our Y axis, this is our Z axis, X, Y, Z, okay? So this is our 3D axis plot, okay? Now we consider some figures here. See how to plot that points in 3D plot. See, again, command is, function is same. X is equal to axis, projection is equal to 3D. Here plot X, Y, Z, and this point is shown by, means like 2D we use the command. We use this plot X, Y, Z. We represent this by DJ diamond. Plot 60, 235 plus M. Plot 50, 87, 30, okay. Plot 20, 257, 65. Means in 3D we plot these four points. X label, Y label, X dot set, set underscore Z label Z. Title plotting points in 3D and show. See how the points look like this. See, these are the four points available. So one point here, and generally we cannot show this point manually. Okay, means we cannot plot this on notebook. But we can consider by using some apps. We can show this graph or we can check this graph. Okay. Now next is helix. Helix graph. Okay. What are the equations of helix? Helix.
Okay, ma'am. R cos t, R sin t, and some p t.
Z coordinate is t.
Yeah.
Okay. X is equal to sin t. We are considering here sin t, cos t. Z is equal to t. Okay. So this is the helix graph. See here again. We directly consider that program because. See here, from matplotlib.py plot import star, import numpy as np. Again, same, x is axis, projection is equal to 3D, z is equal to, now we have to calculate that z. np dot, sorry, we have to take the values of for z. Z is equal to np dot lin space, because for helix, we take z is equal to t or z, t is equal equal to z like that. Okay, x, y, z. We consider z as t, then we consider x as sin t, x as sin t, and y as cos t. Just wait. I'm doing some sin t, cos t. Okay. Z is equal to, so we take the range for z is equal to np dot lin space, 10, 20, 100. Means start with 10, end with 20, we are considering here 100 points. We calculate x as np dot sin z, because x is sin z or sin t, y is cos t, so we calculate y like this. Y is equal to np dot cos z, then x dot plot 3D x, y, z, m. So here for helix, we plot here two helix. Actually, this is only command for helix, but in the same helix, we plot two helix by considering x, y, and y. Means only clockwise and anti-clockwise we consider both the directions here. So see here, x dot set title, set underscore title, helix graph, x label x, y label y, x dot set underscore z label z, show. So if we run this, So this is our helix graph. Okay, this is our helix graph. One is like this. Okay, and other is like this. So these are the two helix. By only changing the position of x and y, we are getting here two helix. Now next one is contour plot. Okay, time goes on increasing. Here, okay, we go fast. Again, here we have to plot your 3D contour plot from matplotlib.py, plot import star, import numpy as a np. We define the function f of x, y. No? Contour plot, we consider z is equal to x square plus y square. Contour is z is equal to x square plus y square. X is equal to, we have to see here. Here we are considering the mesh grid function. This x, y is equal to np dot mesh grid is equal to 3D. Mesh grid means what? This is a function of numpy that is used to create a rectangular grid out of two given one-dimensional arrays. Okay, representing the Cartesian or matrix indexing. Okay, this mesh grid we use for. Z is equal to f of x, y. X is equal to axis, projection is equal to 3D. This we use for contour plot. X dot contour 3D, x, y, z 50, C map is equal to reds. X dot set underscore x label x, y label y. X dot set underscore z label means we are using for labeling x, y, z axis. And this we titleize this as 3D plot. So, yeah. Here. This is our contour. Okay, can we stop or continue? Because time already done. So this is our 3D plot. Okay, in 2 or 3 minutes we can complete this 3D plot. Now next is 3D plot surface. Okay, same thing here. Import function xy, xy mesh grid. This same here. Only we change this. X dot, instead of contour, we consider here x dot plots underscore surface xyz. Here only there is change for contour plot, surface plot. Remaining all things are same and change in title. So here this graph looks like this. Okay, this is our surface plot. Okay. Now next. Okay. Just wait. Okay, I think over. Okay, end of slideshow. Finish. Any doubt up to this? Okay. Now we stop here. Any doubt?